today, you know, a lot of what we're producing is sold through the grain companies and then exported and brought back as finished materials. But that's why it's so critical with having the access to the irrigation the way we do, is to start to produce some of the products ourselves. So whether it's potatoes or it might be carrots or different products that we can grow here, irrigation is hypercritical.
We're sandy. We only get 16 inches of moisture annually, so it is pretty dry. So having guaranteed this $1 million rain, as we call it, it ensures our revenue and food security locally and increases domestic product and all the economic spin-off for the local economy.
There's multiple trades that benefit off of the development, whether it's electricians or welders. There's also several companies that have established and been able to thrive because of the addition of irrigation, whether it's selling machinery or crop inputs. So it's really benefited our smaller communities, and it's been able to sustain multiple jobs that wouldn't otherwise be here.
And I think that's what helps communities thrive. I think when you look at, you know, the irrigation communities that are healthy, that are thriving, I mean, they're thriving. The town's thriving. Not just the irrigation farmers are thriving, but the town's thriving, and I think that's got to be what it's about.
It's a fact that irrigation farmyard to farmyard is about 7 miles. Dryland farmyard to farmyard is about 28 miles. It tells you that people are more prone to live where irrigation has been developed and has been successful, and, you know, the size of the community and the involvement of the community and the sustainability of the community all relates back to that irrigation.
So SIPA is the voice of the irrigators in Saskatchewan. We've really appreciated their connections with government in order to have the channels to speak to the right people, to bring up concerns or roadblocks. They also hear things beyond my yard site, right? Because they are the provincial organization. So challenges that another producer may have over at Elbow or up in Saskatoon might well be something that I have. And when SIPA hears that, they can collectively bring those concerns to the table where we say, oh, okay, this is something that we need to heed and move forward.
It's security, really. Like, food security, I think if you look at the world today, like, it's more relevant than ever. And I know that if you can take the biggest risk out of being a farmer, which is rain, out of the equation, you get security. And to me, food security is critical for the health and well-being of our, not just our communities, not just our province, but us as a country. And when I think of the gift that water is to us, that's what it means.